Hello, everybody, and welcome to this very first episode of my personal playthrough of Resident Evil 7. And it's pretty much the very first Resident Evil game I've ever played. I remember playing the second game for about 1 to 2 hours at a friend's house many years ago, but I've never really played through any of these games from start to finish, and I think it has to do a little bit with the fact that up to now, pretty much all of the games have been in the isometric or at least third-person view, and I'm not really a fan of that, especially in horror games, because I personally feel I have to be in the body of the main character to really feel connected to the game and feel like I'm really there. So I'm really happy to see that with the newest game, they've actually gone down that path, and now Resident Evil 7 is a first-person horror survival game. And from what I've seen, it seems to be a very good one at that as well. And I'm just going to have a quick look at the options here. I've not really had a look what you can actually do. Think I'm going to switch that down a little bit. Speaker, headphones, because I'm using headphones. Display language, subtitles on. Anti-aliasing, motion blur is off. I hate that. I don't really know why people would have liked to have motion blur in games. Makes me feel like I'm drunk. Okay, so far so good. Let's start a new game. I've not played this before. I'm completely blank. I'm going blind into this. I've not watched any footage of the game, so I am completely unaware of what's ahead of me. So we have the choice in difficulty easy or normal. Difficulty cannot be changed mid-game, but yeah, I'm going to go normal because easy is for pussies.
I just wanted to send a quick hello and I love you. Oh, good news! I'm gonna be coming home soon. Yay! I cannot wait to be done with this babysitting job and come home to my loving husband. I miss you. Oh, I gotta get back to work. I love you, Ethan. I miss you so much. I'm sending tons of kisses. Bye, baby.
Ethan, you were right. I did lie to you. I shouldn't have. All I can say is that if you get this, stay away.
Right.
Hey, it's Ethan.
Oh, hey. You all right? You just disappeared the other night.
Yeah, no, I'm good. I'm good. It's Mia. She's not dead. She's alive. She's back.
They found her? How? What happened?
I don't know. Look, I don't know how, but she's back. She's back somehow. Maybe it's a prank, but she wants me to come and get her.
Where is she?
Dalvey. Dalvey, Louisiana.
Dude, it's been 3 years.
I know, but what if it is her? I have to find out what happened.
Okay. So, apparently, we have some guy called Ethan who's on the lookout for his gone missing wife, Mia. Who the hell knows what happened to her? Obviously, she went missing on her job. Some kind of babysitting job.
This is the place.
Ooh, that looks fancy. Look at that. That's a pretty nice car as well. Kind of like typical American muscle car. Right. Yeah. There's only one way to go anyways, and that is forward. Oh, look at that. Check your objective. Find Mia. Yeah. Who would have thought? Right. Can we go in here? No. No, this is locked. Okay. Never mind. That's not gonna work. Oh, what is that?
Shit.
Okay, this doesn't work either. That is a spooky looking house. Look at that. I guess we'll have to find a way around and somehow into that house. And what is that? Sewer Gators, episode 17. Project proposal: sneak into a Louisiana ghost house. Join us. Okay. Any more of interest in here? Accept her gift. What? What gift and who is her? Okay. Let's move on. I have to say the graphics are very nice, even though there's something weird going on with the shadows here. I'm not sure if that's actually related to my graphic settings, but if I hope you can see that on the video, but it's the shadows look a little bit pixelated. Ooh, hi. I can actually crouch. That is good to know. So apparently we are in Louisiana, which is known for its swamps. So that makes kind of sense. Wow. So that looks like bits and pieces of dead horses. Look at that. Who the hell makes something like that? Oh, not actually horses, but no, that's a cow's head, so I guess that's its legs from a cow then. Looked like horse legs at first sight. Right. We've got some dead crows. Whatever happened to them? God only knows. Ooh. It's the creepy ass house, isn't it? Okay. Ooh, there's a bag. Driver's license. And who is that? Is that Mia? Looked like it. Right, let's move on. Is there any way in? don't really have a much of a choice here, so I'm just gonna go in here. Okay. Right, so we are now inside the house. Open door, okay. Shut the door, okay. Okay, we need... What is that? I don't... What does it... Oh... No, I don't really... understand what these four are for. Meastra's license, it's covered in a strange black substance. Print out of the email from your wife Mio, who had been missing for 3 years. Okay, no. That's not gonna be of any use. Right here now. Okay. What is that? Well, it's a picture. We're not entirely sure who it's depicting. It looks like it could be Mio there. But I mean, I'm going to ramp up the camera sensitivity. Okay, that should be good. Oh, this is locked as well. Yeah, okay. Over 20 missing in 2 years. Ghost sighted and by you. Yeah. Okay, oh. That's the fridge. What's it in? Oh, wow. No. Wow, you can even see like larvae and worms moving in there. That's pretty disgusting. Wow, and a dead crow. Is it somebody even living here? I mean, this looks like... It looks like a hole. Doesn't really look like anybody's living here. Oh, we're gonna check out this floor completely first, before I move up. Okay, there's nothing here. Can't open that up. I can't open that one either, so I guess we're gonna go up. Right. What is that blinking thingy? Is that a trap? Not responding. What the heck is that? Oh, okay, that's a power socket. And... ooh. Save slots. Okay. Nice. Oh, a VHS tape to get it out correctly. But... where do we use that? I didn't see a TV. Oh, I'm just gonna save up this. Thanks. Okay. So, well, this is a dead end, pretty much. We can't open this up. There's nothing else to do other than to go back down. Hmm. So, where do I go? Maybe back outside? I don't know. Okay, now I can't. Oh, this is locked now.
Damn.
Guess we'll have to find a way to actually play that VHS tape. There's a door here, probably going down into the cellar. Oh, okay, I didn't know that it's actually open. It didn't tell me. Rotate, okay. That's a young woman with barely any clothes on. Some... What? Okay. That just me, or looks like a prison cell. Could be in the cellar, actually. Okay. Never mind. That looks like some guy standing over a sleeping woman. And then we can actually put the VHS tape in and have a look.
Drew! Where did you find this guy?
Give me a break, Pete.
Hey!
Oh, we can now actually play this part. So we're basically looking into the past and we can actually actively take part in it. That's actually pretty nice.
This new guy? I'm not feeling it.
Again?
Just don't be surprised if we have to make a change. New plan. We do a walkthrough of the inside first, then we shoot the intro.
Just like we always do. Just try to say the show's name this time, okay?
No problem. Tonight on Sewer Gators, another worthless fucking shithole. Happy? Ecstatic.
Okay. Seems like they're recording some kind of amateur show. I guess they're gonna be up for a nasty surprise.
Are we rolling? Alright, let's go.
There we connect. Wow, look at that. There's actually moths flying around the light bulb.
It's
just a nice detail. Yeah, that's the same way we went in.
So, why are we in hell this time? Do you ever prep? What's the prep? Shitty house, spooky sounds? Ooh, is it haunted? Fuck me. I was an anchor, you know?
Weekend sub, Pete. Not anchor.
What's that?
Nothing.
I didn't check the date of the VHS tape, but it must be quite a few years back because nobody's using VHS anymore.
The usual.
How long did you say this place has been abandoned?
3 years.
Clancy, the door has closed on us.
Let's make a great cutaway. So, Hillbilly Joe and his family go missing.
Not hillbillies, the Bakers. Jack and Marguerite Baker. And they were quiet, not backward. A lot of bad rumors about their son, Lucas. Bad seed, apparently.
Ah, shit! I know I should have worn my good shoes. Oh, shit. Glad I had my shots. Although... this would make a great
still
backdrop.
Looks like a crap hole.
Andre, what do you think? Andre?
Oh, isn't that the Andre. Same?
Ooh. Andre!
Uh-oh.
Clancy, you see where Andre went?
No. I didn't really take note.
Where is he? Fucking believable. This is the last time I work with that guy. I mean, producers, they come and go, but a good cameraman like you, Clancy, you stick with me.
Hey, wherever he went. Okay, this looks pretty much identical to the state it is right now.
What the fuck was that? Did you hear that?
Can't open that. Guess he's going to open it anyways.
Andre? Where the fuck is he? Andre, where are you, man?
Oh, there's a fuse missing. Oh, this is getting spoopy.
What the hell?
What?
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Wow.
Alright, new deal. We find Andre and we go. I mean, fuck this show.
Okay, is that the Baker family? Oh. So, what did he actually... Oh, there's a handle here, so that can be manipulated, I guess. It's good to know. Oh, come on, man, don't
you
go
first.
Down there. What?
Need a nice hero shot of me coming down the ladder. You first.
Well, shit. Right.
What do you see? What is it?
I know, it's a shithole. That's what it is. I know. Oh! Wow, Blair Witch Project. Shit. Hey, man. Oh. Uh-oh. Okay. That was quite nasty.
Jesus.
Yeah. Oh, look. The fuse is still missing. Right. Guess we're gonna try and open that up. Looks like the owners. God, I have a bad feeling about this. Not the cleanest of places with all these cockroaches around. I don't even know why I'm going down there. I mean, I've watched a VHS tape. Yeah. And that happened.
Damn it.
I mean... Guys, seriously, if you watched a VHS tape of people getting killed down here, would you go down here to investigate all by yourself? Would you? I know I sure wouldn't do. Sure as hell I wouldn't. Yeah, I think I heard something. Well, okay, we're right in the middle of a friggin' puddle of water and dirt. Okay. What? God damn it, game. Stop playing with me. Whoa! God damn it. That's the first jump scare. Wow. Good lord. You've seen better days. What is that? Kind of like notes that people put up of people gone missing? I don't know. That's my guess. Open this up? No. Okay. Just heard something open. Oh, there's like a cell. Oh, look at that. Is that Mia? Could be. Look at that. Oh, Ben, dead. Harold turned. Arthur turned. Tamara turned. Greg dead. Layla dead. Sean dead. William dead. Travis turned. Peter dead. Andre dead. Clancy L? Oh, Mia doesn't say anything. Mighty turned, Clyde dead, Lindsay turned, Stephen turned, Nathaniel dead, Edward dead, Nadine dead, Alex dead, Tom dead, Reed turned, Susan turned, Joseph dead, David dead. Well, that doesn't say specifically what happened to Mia. Oh, nice. Actually use that on here. Yeah. Cut that up. Nice. Let's open that up.
Mia. Oh, thank God I found you. It's me. It's Ethan.
Ethan? Ethan?
Are you alright?
You shouldn't be here.
What do you mean? You contacted me.
No. No, I wouldn't. Did I? Did anyone see you? Did he see you?
Hey, who else is here? What the hell's going on?
Daddy's coming. We need to go.
Daddy?
We need to go now!
Hey, sounds like we're in a bit of trouble.
Where are you taking me?
Someplace safe.
Are you gonna tell me what's going on? Baby, you've been gone 3 years.
3 years? Has it really been 3 years?
Yes, it's been 3 years. And seems like she didn't turn for the better in those 3 years. What's going on?
What is this place? What'd they do to you?
Not now. We need to get out of here first.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here first, and then questions later. What is that? What the heck is that? What the heck?
Mia, we have to talk. That message you sent me.
Not me. That wasn't me!
But you did.
I didn't!
Okay, fine. Just tell me what's going on.
I'm telling you everything that I know. We have to go this way.
Let's go.
Mia, are you sure you know where you're going?
The family used to bring me food through here. I remember.
Let's go through here.
There. It's there.
Okay. Come on. Open
this
up. Open up.
I remember this room. There's another door here. I'm sure of it.
Is there anything of interest?
It's gone! It's gone!
What? How can it be gone?
We're gonna be a family. Now that you're here.
What? What are you talking about?
There's another door here. I'm sure of it.
E001. Okay. Oh, and a spoopy old lady. E001. I wonder what that is all about. Maybe some kind of code combination. Something. Oh, what is that? Is that doll representing Mia? If that's the case, what is this doll?
No, leave me alone!
Mia?
Oh, okay. Alright, alright, alright. Ooh, where's that leading to? Okay, you know guys, I think that's enough for this very first episode. So, we found Mia, somebody or something took her away from us. I guess we'll have to go around the house trying to find her. So, yeah. This game already is very, very, very immersive. I have to say, the graphics. Absolutely top-notch. Absolutely stunning. Yeah, so... I guess, I hope... Can I actually stop this right here? I hope so. No, actually I have to play until I find a safe... safe place, right? Okay, well, I guess I'm not quitting right now, then. Right, because there's no autosave, right? Or is there? Guest house map. Okay. Right, anyways, I'm going to hazard it, and I'm going to stop this first part right here and right now. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and let's see what we are up against in this house. Right, so... until next time, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you in my next video.
Go tell Aunt Rhody that everybody